Did you know that your chances of encountering a Florida black bear are greater today than at any time in the past 100 years? It's true. So it's never been more important for you to know how to share Florida's changing landscape with this amazing animal. Bears are living somewhere out there, and there, and lots of other areas in the state. Maybe even a lot of bears. They live in dense forests and are spread out over very large areas. Biologists see signs bears have left behind, like tracks, scat, and trees that they have marked.
I'm Walter McCown, a wildlife biologist with Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. My job is to conduct black bear research. In this study, our objectives are to estimate the number of bears in Florida. I say estimate because counting bears or conducting a census is just not possible for bears. They're shy, secretive. They live in thickets and swamps. One of them pretty much looks like another one. They travel a lot. Counting bears really can't be done.
However, biologists are able to get a good estimate of the number of bears in an area using a technique called capture, mark, and recapture.
Which is a fancy way of saying that we are going to detect bears, identify them individually to mark them, and then over a series of weeks, look at the proportion of new bears that are marked or identified versus the numbers that were already marked or identified.
To demonstrate, let's say these bear shapes represent bears living in one of the national forests in Florida. To use capture, mark, and recapture, we set up barbed wire corrals, also called hair snares, by running barbed wire around four trees in the area we want to study. We mark the area and identify it as a research site to alert the public. Then we bait the corrals with donuts and other bear attractants. The bears enter to get the attractants, and when they leave a sample of hair on the barbed wire, they have been captured. We must mark some of these bears, and we do that by collecting the bear hair from the barbed wire. When we use DNA analysis to identify each individual bear that leaves a sample of hair, we have the marked portion of the total population. Let's say this group of 100 marked shapes are individual bears we have identified or marked in this way. They have been marked, but they are still just a part of the total population of bears in the forest. Later, when we go back and catch bears again in the same area, a portion of our next captures will contain marked bears, and a portion will be previously unmarked. Okay, let's say this is our next set of captured bears. We count the number of unmarked bears and get 50, and the number of previously marked bears and get 20. From these numbers, we can estimate the total number of bears in the woods. We use the results of this simple equation, along with some complex mathematical calculations, to give us that estimate. N equals MC over R, where N is the estimate of the total population size, what we're looking for. M is the total number of bears captured and marked, 100. C is the total number of bears captured in a given time period, 70. And R is the number of marked bears we caught in the same period, 20. Using our formula, we get an estimate of 350. We perform this a number of times over a summer, the season of the year when bears are most active, and then average the results, making some statistical adjustments to account for differences in how bears get caught. We end up with a pretty good estimate of the number of bears in the forest. To learn more about living and recreating in Florida bear country, go to the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission's Black Bear website at myfwc.com/bear.